My name is Ray Saldaña. I am 28 years old. I grew up on the south side of San Antonio, and I went to South San Antonio High School. I went to Stanford University, and I got my undergraduate there and my graduate degree. San Antonio, the place where I grew up, is a place with, we say in Spanish, mucho corazón, with a lot of heart, and you see it in its people. You see it in the high school that I went to. It's authentic and it's real in a way that makes it exciting for me to say that yo soy de San Antonio, that I'm from San Antonio. South San is a great place. It's a great high school, but I can't say that it is the best place to find the support that you need. There wasn't a strong sense of support, and there certainly wasn't a high bar for expectations. I realized that when I spoke to adults or authority figures asking about my future, that the bar was significantly lower for me than it was for a student across town. I have parents who didn't graduate from high school, didn't pass middle school. So they relied on these adults to set high expectations and provide support, but it wasn't easily found at my high school. I struggled in high school because everything leading up to high school pointed to indicators that I wouldn't graduate. It was not being able to speak English during my first day of school. It was coming from a family in which my parents didn't make it past the eighth grade, and coming into from an environment or a community where I knew more people that went to prison than I knew went to college or graduated from high school. The struggle and the turning point really comes when you get somebody in your life to tell you that they believe that you have potential, and you trust and believe that they actually are telling you the truth. And I ran into that with college advisors. In my case, it was communities and schools advisors, Miss Bell and Miss Reyes. I've always seen them as role models that stepped in right at the moment in which I needed them to tell me about a bar that was higher than I had known growing up in my community. So the struggle of not having a high school diploma isn't something I saw in a movie or read in a book. They were friends of mine. They were my parents. And the realness of that is that you see a struggle that means your job is never secure, your next paycheck is never secure, the next area where you'll find healthcare is never secure. My father is a first-generation American. He was an immigrant to this country. It becomes a way of life that you start to think about success, not for yourself, but for your son or your daughter. So they realized if this was a race, there's going to be a relay in which they were not going to be able to reach the end of that race. And whether it was being economically secure, it was understanding how to navigate any system around a job or having job security, those things are tough to grasp when you don't have a high school diploma. I was lucky enough to have parents who said, you are gonna graduate high school. We don't know how you're gonna make it happen, and you're gonna have to find the support you need to get across that stage, but you're gonna graduate high school. In a lot of ways, what you're seeing in me is what I would like to call the new face of the American dream, where there is a country who is supporting young Latinos, who is supporting students who are coming up through the ranks of our country, and finding themselves in position of leadership. And so that will mean that if we are getting it right by young minorities struggling to get through high school, we're gonna be getting it right as a country. The graduation effect for me was that doors that were before closed are now open. And I've taken every opportunity to walk through each and every one of them, whether it was going to college, coming back and running for office, getting the lead in my community. None of those things would have been possible had I not yet had a high school diploma. The best part of my job is when I get to talk to high school students or elementary students or middle school students and provide to them a role model of somebody that looks like them, that came from their neighborhoods, that walked their streets, that is now an example that they can use. My name is Ray Saldaña, and I'm a first-generation American, college graduate. I am the youngest San Antonio City Councilman ever elected. I am the face of the American dream, and it all began with a high school diploma.